Hello children, welcome back to the class. So last class, last lecture, we were doing principles of inheritance and variation, and we did one gene inheritance, and now we'll do two genes. So I had shown you the crossings, and I had left you over here, and asked you to practice at home and do the crossings and do it for yourself. And today, just check what you have done with me. So we'll do it again. This, as I told you, the parents segregation, and after segregation the gametes which we form. So this is the male, the circle and the arrow sign which is there, this is for male and this is female. So we have four types of gametes, and you know that we are doing two genes. So one is for color and one is for shape. So capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. The same over here. So how do we do? We take one and we cross the other one. So this is like this, then this goes with this, capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital R, small r, capital Y and small y. Come to this, capital R, capital Y and small y, capital R, small y and small y, capital R, small r, capital Y and small y, capital R, small y and small y. Okay. So this small r, capital Y, small r, capital Y and small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small r. Okay? So small r, capital Y, small y. It's telling what you have done with this. Okay? So capital r, capital Y, small y, small r, capital Y and small y. Capital R, Y, and Y. As I told you earlier in the earlier class, you can write anyone before, anyone after. And when we write both these together, it is difficult for you to find out the dominance on the basis of dominance, law of dominance. Okay, so this will show what you will have to write over here only. This RR will be completely round and yellow. Got it? So this will also be round and yellow. Okay, why? Because in the presence of a dominant gene, this recessive will not be able to express itself. This will also be round and yellow. This will also be round and yellow. Now this will be round and green. Okay, both the recessives we have. So when we have homozygous recessive, then it will express itself. Now here this will be wrinkled. Small r, small r. So this will be wrinkled. And this will be wrinkled and yellow. This will be wrinkled and green. Okay, this will be wrinkled and yellow. This will be round and yellow. This will again be wrinkled. Yellow. This will be round and yellow. This will again be round and yellow. As I told you, law of dominance will prove everywhere. Okay, this is the shape and this is the color. So again round and green. Okay, so round, yellow. This is again round and yellow, and this is again round and yellow. Okay children, it's easier for you to do it like this. You can check it with whatever you have done. And when to find out actually what is the number of different constructions. So what we do, we'll see which one is how much. So round and yellow numbers, okay, then we'll see round and green. Okay, we'll see
wrinkled and yellow.
Wrinkled and yellow and wrinkled and green. Clear? So count down round and yellow seeds. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So you have round and yellow, 9 seeds. Then you have round and green. Round and green, three seeds, okay, wrinkled and yellow, three seeds, and this is the recessive one. So what is the ratio at the end? This is Mendel's second law of inheritance. Okay, so this is 9:3:3:1. Now children, this is very, very important. From the board examination point of view, you are asked to prove this. Okay, so you must know it, you must know the crossing. As I had continued, this is the just the continuation of the last class, so you must remember it. Now law of independent assortment also goes with it. Okay, what is law of independent assortment? That both the characters, one is for shape and one is for color, they are not dependent upon each other, they are completely interdependent. Okay, so finally what happens, you can see round and yellow, okay, both are dominant, but then somewhere you can see round and green as well. Yes, here you can see round and green. Now round is dominant but green is recessive, and when round is dominant, green is recessive, still in the presence of this dominant, the recessive does not become dominant, or it is able to express itself in whatever condition it is without being dependent on what the other constituent is showing. So law of independent assortment. So we did law of dominance. It is proved, law of dominance, capital R small r, capital R, capital R small r, round is proved, R proves itself. So that is law of dominance. Law of segregation, when we did that, both the genes are segregated, they are separated. And law of independent assortment, without the presence, without being dependent upon each other, both the genes, so as many characteristics we study together, we are studying shape and size, they will assort themselves independently without being dependent on the other character. So I'll complete, I want to go topic wise so that your topics are clearer. So I'll stop it over here to revise it, check it, do it, and I'll continue with it in the next lecture. Hope you have enjoyed my classes. Okay, do revise it, keep asking your doubts. If you don't post your doubts, I won't know whether you understand or not. Okay, so best wishes, good luck, thank you.